Probably the most gifted and certainly the most prolific of the three composers whose work we've just heard was Bortnianski. After completing his studies in Italy, he returned to St. Petersburg and became the director of the court choir, which consisted mostly of Ukrainians and which he raised to a new level of excellence. During this period, he composed over 100 choral religious works. And in these compositions, he combined the age-old traditions of Ukrainian choral music with the achievements of late 18th century West European music. Concentrating on the purely vocal a cappella style, Bortnianski reached a high level of technical proficiency in his sacred music, and at the same time, he managed to express a deep spiritual mood. We're going to hear two more of his compositions before the interval, both of them in arrangements for choir and soloists by Andriy Gnatishyn. Now, Gnatishyn is one of the most distinguished of living Ukrainian composers. He lives at present in Vienna. He was born in Western Ukraine and studied in Lviv and subsequently at the Vienna Conservatoire, where he later became professor of music. He's composed a variety of orchestral, chamber, and vocal works, both religious and secular. The last two items, these two items by Bortnianski, which end the first part of our program, will be conducted by Dr. Miroslav Antonovich.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the second half of this marvelous concert. The first three works in the second half represent 19th and 20th century Ukrainian church music. The first is Glory Be to the Father, Only Begotten Son by Mikhailo Verbitsky. Verbitsky was a priest in the Ukrainian Catholic Church, and among his compositions are settings of various parts of the liturgy and other choral works, as well as several orchestral pieces. Verbitsky also wrote the music for the Ukrainian national anthem that we heard at the beginning. In his religious compositions, he alludes to the work of Bortnianski, who was Orthodox, thereby reflecting an ecumenical spirit. The second work, Praise the Name of the Lord by Kirilo Stetsenko, reveals new trends in Ukrainian church music, which appear at the beginning of the 20th century. There are traces of an attempt to unite ancient Ukrainian musical traditions with Ukrainian folk song elements to create a national style, if you like, in Ukrainian church music. Stetsenko was a Ukrainian Orthodox priest. During the period of Ukrainian independence, following the collapse of the Tsarist Russian Empire in 1917, he was very active in organizing musical life in Ukraine. And his compositions include two liturgies, operas, vocal solos, and arrangements of Ukrainian folk songs. The third item, All Creation Rejoices in You, is a Marian hymn from the Liturgy of St. Basil the Great, performed during Lent. Now, this is a very famous arrangement of an old Ukrainian liturgical melody presented in a simple harmonization resembling monastic singing in the Ukraine, and the arrangement is by Miroslav Antonovich, who will conduct it. But the first two items are conducted by the conductor of the New York Dumka Choir, Semen Komirny.
Oh. Alone.
Thank you.
Well, now, that marvellous prayerful singing is heard in Ukrainian churches before Easter. And now we're going to move on to the joyous celebrations of Easter itself, the celebration of Christ's resurrection. First, we're going to hear a version of Christos Voskres, or Christ is Risen, a hymn from the Easter Mass. And a distinctive feature of this particular version is that we hear the echo of Easter bells. And following that, we're going to have a performance of traditional Ukrainian spring ritual songs and dances. In western Ukraine, the songs are called Khachilka, and in central and eastern Ukraine, Vesnyanka. In western Ukraine, they've been almost completely separated from their seasonal connection and incorporated into the church calendar. They're sung during Easter. Elsewhere, they've preserved their seasonal nature, and they're sung when the snow begins to thaw in the hills and throughout the spring. And the songs are often combined with ritual dance, as in the performance we're going to see. They sometimes take the form of a dialogue between two groups of performers, and the songs are usually cheerful and often humorous. And the dances will be performed by the Orlik Ensemble, with choreography by Maria Babich and Dmytro Paradyuk. Now, the conductor, and then we're going to hear after that, I should have told you, a second version of Christ is Risen, this time written by Pilip Kozitsky, one of a new generation of Ukrainian composers who emerged in the 20s and the 30s in Ukraine. Now, the conductor at this point comes from Toronto. She's the conductor of the Canadian Vesnivka Choir. Incidentally, that word means springtime, and she is Mrs. Kvitka Kondratska.
Yeah. Yeah.
But now we've got two more items to complete today's celebration. The first of them, a setting of the psalm, Give Glory to the Lord, was written especially to mark the millennium of Ukrainian Christianity by the composer who's with us tonight, Andriy Natishin. In its musical style and spirit, the work is closely linked to the traditions of church music in Ukraine, and the work bears witness to the unity of Ukrainians outside Ukraine with their compatriots in their homeland. The conductor is Yaroslav Babunyak. Is Miroslav Butchok. I apologize for my error. Well, before we come to the last item in this very memorable concert, I'm sure you'd like to thank once again a number of the people who are not on the platform at the moment who've taken part in the concert. First of all, our marvelous dancers. Conductors, Miroslav Antonovich, Yaroslav Babunyak, Alina Kvitka-Kondratska, Semen Komirny, Pavlo Hunka, Miroslav Buchok, and Stepan Hunka. Two choreographers who arranged the dances, Maria Babich and Dmitro Paradyuk. Now somebody to whom I think we all owe a tremendous debt of gratitude, the coordinator of this event, who's certainly been doing 2 years hard labor at the very least on it, with wonderful results, Vladimir Lucid. Well, now we do come to the last item in the program. Alas, it's a hymn by Mykola Lysenko, one of the best known of Ukrainian composers. His works are really full of Ukrainian folk elements, and they're very national in feeling, like other romantic composers such as Grieg and Smetana and so on. And the hymn is sung, I'm told, by Ukrainians in Europe, America, Australia. Some of you may feel inclined to join in, perhaps. And everywhere, in fact, it's sung where people, Ukrainian people, feel free to profess their faith. And the words of the first verse, I think, wonderfully express the spirit and purpose of this great celebration. O great and only God, protect our Ukraine, light her with the rays of freedom. Thank you.